못했는 말 지금 전할게요.
Lim Ji-young reads the suicide note of her 13-year-old son. Sung-min jumped out of the seventh-floor window of the family home 7 months ago because he was being bullied at school. Her son's final words describe how he was robbed and beaten by boys in his class. Electrical wire was tied around his neck and he was burned with lighters. Lim does not want to show her face on camera. She's only told close friends and family how her son died. She had no idea he was being bullied. She relives the day police called her to come home. When she arrived, she saw a body outside her apartment block, covered in a white cloth. I pulled back the cloth and saw my son, she says. I put my arms around him and felt he was still warm. I said he's still alive and I called for a doctor, but they told me he's already dead. When I looked up, I saw the open window. His bedroom has not been touched since that day. The parents and older brother all have trouble sleeping. As a teacher herself, Lim says schools are not doing enough to protect their students. The school wants to cover it up, she says. Just 5 months before my son killed himself, a girl in the same grade committed suicide because of bullying. But nothing was done, so it happened again.
The school in question declined to comment, but it's certainly not the only one with problems. In 2010, more than 350 teenagers between the ages of 10 and 19 committed suicide. That's almost one every day. Now, the main reason for youth suicide in South Korea is concerns over school grades, but school violence is also a significant factor.
The problem has been recognized by the government. Counselling centres will be set up in 40% of schools by the end of this year. So-called WE classes, standing for WE, Education, Emotion. This counsellor tells me, before a student feels suicidal, he or she has gone through a lot of pain. If counsellors intervene early enough, the child can be saved. Cho Hyun-jun is 17 years old and came to ask advice for his friend who's being bullied. He says bullying victims have a hard time because they feel there's no one they can ask for help, so a place like this is really important. Schools are also trying to put more focus on team sports rather than just celebrating individual success. Counselors say intense competition in Korean schools can lead to bullying. Government figures suggest school violence, although still high, has started to decrease. Too late for this 13-year-old and another South Korean family destroyed by bullying and suicide. Paula Hancocks, CNN, South Korea.